Good morning, my dear beloved student. I am Dr. Imu Ghosh, Assistant Professor of Physiology, Arden Sukrinya Women's Medical College. Today I will give you a lecture on the different lung function tests and their relationship with the different lung disease. Okay. So first of all, we have to learn there are so many lung function tests in the to diagnosis of the lung disease. Most common lung function tests for diagnosis of the lung disease are the lung volumes and capacities that is measured by the spirogram and then FEV1 that is forced expiratory volume in first second by another spirogram and FVC that is forced vital capacity and their ratio that is FEV1 FVC ratio and peak expiratory flow rate and so many lung volume and capacities can be done by this so many tests by the spirometer and another test is the airway resistance test, then another test is the blood gas analysis test and so many tests are done for diagnosis of the lung disease. The most common we have already told that is the lung volume and capacities, FVC that is forced vital capacity, FEV1 and their ratio and peak expiratory flow rate. Okay. For diagnosis of different lung disease, this test can be helpful for differentiate between different lung disease. So we now learn about what are the lung disease. So broadly, according to the functional physiology, but defect in the functions that can be divided into two, that is obstructive lung disease and restrictive lung disease. So in obstructive lung disease, that the definition of the obstructive lung disease is that if there is an obstruction in any part of the respiratory tract. So if there is an obstruction in the respiratory tract and that will lead to some disease, the condition that is called obstructive lung disease. The most common causes or most common example of the obstructive lung disease is asthma. As you know, you have heard already in normal person, and another one is COPD, that is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. And within the chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, they have two components, that is chronic bronchitis and emphysema. So this is about the obstructive lung disease. And another one is the restrictive lung disease. Restriction means, as the definition of the restrictive lung disease, as you know that lung tissue is an elastic tissue, so it has an expand characteristic and that can come back to the normal. And whenever this elasticity is lost, that will lead to a restriction of the expansion. That is called restrictive lung disease. So most common example of the restrictive lung disease is fibrosing alveolitis by interstitial lung disease, or another one is the pulmonary congestion or pulmonary edema. Okay, so these are the two lung disease, that is obstructive lung disease and restrictive lung disease. So by the application of this lung function test, we can differentiate between these two, obstructive lung disease and restrictive lung disease. The first point of the differentiation between the obstructive and restrictive lung disease is the cause. No, what is the cause behind the obstructive lung disease? Usually, what will be the effect of obstructive lung disease? Actually, obstructive lung disease occur due to effect in the airway resistance is increased due to obstruction in the pathway, so expiration is affected. Okay, and in restrictive lung disease, usually the elasticity of the lung is lost, that is why they cannot take air within the lung and that can be expired, so expiration is not affected. Okay, now the FEV1, no, that is forced expiratory volume in first second, that I have already told in previous lecture, that is if the expiration is divided into three part, first, second, whatever it is passed out, that is called FEV1. So expiration, as it is affected in the obstructive lung disease, so FEV1 is markedly reduced in which disease? Obstructive lung disease. And as because the expiration is not affected in the restrictive lung disease, so it is remain in normal. And next one is the FVC, that is forced vital capacity. So here expiration and inspiration is required, so it is decreased in both lung disease. It is decreased in both lung disease, that is obstructive lung disease and restrictive lung disease. And if we ratio the FEV1 with the FVC ratio, then in obstructive lung disease it is markedly reduced, near about 50%, as because APP1 is also affected and FVC is also affected, okay? And restrictive lung disease, the ratio, that is APP1 FVC ratio, is maybe normal or maybe increased, as because APP1 is not affected markedly or not affected at all in the restrictive lung disease, but the FVC is reduced. So numerator is unaffected and denominator is affected, then the ratio may be normal or increased. And now the lung volumes, that is the total lung volume and residual volume, as I have already told you that the expiration is affected from the beginning. I am telling this, the expiration is affected. So the air will enter into the lung, but that cannot be expired. Okay. So the residual volume and the total lung volume can be increased in the obstructive lung disease, but in case of restrictive lung disease, residual volume, total lung volume, but total, functional residual capacity is not increased so much, okay, but not increased at all. The total lung capacity is increased as well as in the obstructive lung disease, and total lung capacity is not increased in restrictive lung disease. So these are the differentiate point between the obstructive and restrictive lung disease. Most important differentiating point is the FEV1, that is markedly reduced in obstructive lung disease, and that is usually not affected in the restrictive lung disease. So this is all about the lung function test, regarding the lung function test and the lung disease. Thank you very much.